It's a great way to start because your pets have no opinion about what you say. They love it when you come home. They just love you, period. And it's a great way to start to feel what unconditional love can feel like. Because that truly is our mission, friends, to know this sense of unconditional love and to live it. So we have to sort of learn it before we can live it. And we do this each day, and we learn more, and we come into communities like this where we get to experience the love that you are so you can go out and be that love. A wonderful affirmation that just is a simple unity affirmation that we, you know, you want to keep your affirmations simple so you can feel them is, I am love. And I'd like for us just to practice this in our recognition time this morning. So if you'll close your eyes and picture an event, a person, a situation that feels like conditional love for you, that feels uncomfortable, some angst around it, a person that you just wish was different. And say to yourself, I'm going to say it three times, and I'd like just to say it to yourself in a whisper, I am love. And apply it, allow this to encompass and encircle this situation. Okay, three times. I am love. I am love. I am love. And let's take a breath. And just open your eyes. And not acknowledge how that shift happened in that relationship from just understanding the love that you bring to whatever that situation is. It's not that that person needs to change. It's not that that situation needs to change, but your idea of it needs to change. A spiritual solution to every problem. And that problem has come into your life for you to acknowledge, I am love. And you can see that shift just in that moment. And if we practice that every day, your whole life will shift. Not because that person changed or that experience changed, but because you changed. We have so many tools here at Unity that allow us to recognize that love that we are. Certainly coming here, we have classes that we offer. We have the Silent Unity prayer line that you can call to know who more love that you are. And certainly reading our daily word every day will remind us of the love that we are. And if you don't have a copy of Daily Word, you can go to www.dailyword.com. You know, there are so many tools that we have here at Unity to remind us of the love that we are. So recognition. We have to recognize that we are coming from a place of conditional love, moving into unconditional love. And the second piece is to realize that as we have this gift, this is such a gift, friends. We've all been chosen to be here at a center of well-being, a community of love, where we get to wake up and realize who we are, and then we get to take this out into the world. The world needs you. The world needs you to know who you are. We still have a lot of disputes going on. We still have a lot of challenges going on that you get to bring that love that you are. And do you recognize that when you go out in the community, just getting out onto the street, do you feel I am love? Or are we looking for, you know, the person that cuts us off so we can, you know, have something to grumble about that day? And do we notice places? I notice all the time when I'm in places where it's kind of crowded and stress is going on that I feel that me against you experience. And one of those places that I see this happens a lot is airports. Y'all been to airports lately? I mean, I love traveling, but those airports have become really stressful places. You know, they're going to charge you about your bag weight, so you're not going to put so much stuff in your bag anymore. And then all that stuff goes in your carry-on, but then they've got all kinds of rules about your carry-on, too. And you got, you know, the ounces thing, and then they take your bottle of water away, and you have to take off practically, you know, all your clothes to get through the security. So you're just stressed a lot in airports, and people are walking around with their agenda and their mission, and really people aren't connecting with one another. I notice when I go in, is Wilson here today? No, but when I go into the airport, we have a wonderful Unity member that's a security guard. And I'll go through and I'm, you know, all okay, everything in the box, and did I forget my shampoo and all these things. And I hear Wilson, who's usually sitting right up there, say, "Hey, Heidi, great talk yesterday." And all of a sudden, I have engaged in I am love again. I have realized that I'm not this separate being, that I'm connected once again. So airports are one of those places. And there was a wonderful story I read on the internet that reminded me of how I want to realize that I'm living on a planet of wonderful people that are all trying to allow spiritual solutions to happen to their problems. And maybe if I paid attention to what was going on around me in my world and lived from that place of I am love, I could have that sense of what Valentine's Day offers us every day of the year. Elsie Clark, a 79-year-old grandmother, was traveling right after Christmas back home to Canada. Elsie has a hip challenge, and she has to travel in a wheelchair when she is in airports. Well, Elsie had been left at the wrong terminal for hours from an airline employee that just didn't take her to the right place, and so she missed her flight, and they rescheduled on another flight that went through Chicago on her way to Canada. Well, Elsie was very disheveled, and she was sitting waiting at this gate, waiting to get on the plane. And she always had admired people with shiny shoes. And she was sitting next to a man with shiny shoes. So she decided she would engage in a conversation with this man to get her mind off her troubles. And so she engaged with this man, and she was telling him what was going on with her, and he started telling her what was going on with him. And they started realizing they had this connection, like we all do with everyone on this planet. And this man, now you know when people are starting to talk to you at airports, do you put your nose a little deeper in your book or in your newspaper, or you just, you know, like that Eddie Arnold song, Make the World Go Away? Or do you start to engage with the things that are going on around you? Well, Dean Germeyer engaged with Elsie Clark, and he listened to her story. And he realized that I am love, and I'm being called to live this life of love that is mine to do. I recognize I sat by this woman because life is in divine order, and I have some loving to do. So he arranged with the airlines for a flight attendant to meet he and Elsie on the other end of the flight, and he wheeled Elsie down to her flight to Chicago to make sure she got on the plane. Well, the flight had left. So what would we do? Well, Elsie, good luck with this flight thing, and, you know, good luck. They gave Elsie a hotel voucher that wasn't enough, really, for the hotel and all of her experience. So Dean Germeyer decided to continue to live from that place of love. And he called his wife, and he said, set another setting at the dinner table. I'm bringing this Elsie Clark home. And he brought her home. They fed her dinner. He went on to take her on a little short city tour after dinner, and he set her up at a hotel on Madison Avenue and set up a car for her to go to the airport the next day. Because Dean Germeyer decided that love was his decision. Love was his way of life. I am love. And they interviewed Elsie later, the Chicago Tribune, when they heard about this story that was told by a chaplain at the airport. And Elsie said when she got to the hotel, she just cried and cried and cried. She said, "This guy even gave me toothpaste and a toothbrush." And she said, "It just changed my life that he was so kind." But who is it that really got the gift? Dean Germeyer. Because Dean realized that he was love. He realized that this was an opportunity to grow in his understanding of who he was. He realized that life was not something you push away and you avoid, so it's just so inconvenient to connect with people. He said, "This is my opportunity," and he listened. He realized. So we recognize where we've come from with love. We want to realize that we are one with everyone, and we always have these opportunities to grow. And finally, we want to have reverence. We want to have reverence for the spirit that's housed in your human body. And that, yes, life is a human experience, but we are always called to awaken spiritually.